Hi everyone, welcome back to Cody's Lab. So I've got here a jug of about 50 pounds of mercury, and I've brought this down along with seven other flasks. And I've also built a reinforced box, which is lined with plastic. I've got some 2x4s and some concrete. Mercury is incredibly heavy. An aquarium wouldn't handle it. And today we're gonna see if this liquid metal is dense enough for me to stand on. There we go. I didn't want those leaking, did I? So I freshly distilled a bunch of this. So we should be putting all together all my clean mercury. I like how it makes bubbles. See that? You can actually see bubbles in the... That is actually air bubbles in the mercury. It's almost like soapy water. One of eight. All right, so here's the last flask. It works really well to pour it from the level of the mercury. That way it doesn't splash. Oh, my hands are freezing. I think the mercury's temperature right now is about -1 Celsius or 30 degrees Fahrenheit. This mercury should be clean. I did distill it once. I mean, it's not triple distilled, but it looks like most of this that's on top is literally just dust. Ready for this? See how much I can get off just by squeegeeing off the top. Oh, that's nice. Now, I would do this barefoot to give people something to comment on. Mercury's not as bad as most people think. But I do have an open wound from an ingrown toenail on my other foot, so I think I will put on a pair of boots. Okay, I think we're ready. Let's see what happens. Definitely does not want my foot down in there. Oh, such pressure. Okay, second one. See if I can go up. Well, I'm floating on it. It's not easy. Okay, okay, I think. Oh. It's hard to keep the feet like down at the same level. Okay, okay. I can kind of brace myself against the side of the container, and I am floating on it. There's about an inch of mercury underneath my feet. If I pull my feet away from the side so I don't use that. Okay, okay. It's like trying to balance a broom on your hand. Oh, except I'm the broom. Okay, I fell over. Oh, it's actually hard to get back up because I have to put my weight on them to get them to go back down. Let me actually set this foot all the way down and let's mark it with a marker. What level I'm sinking. So my foot's all the way at the bottom of the container and I'm to there. All right, let me put my other one in. Here, I'm gonna take that marker. Oh. See, you can clearly see that I am indeed floating. See, boing, boing. Here, okay. Prove I'm not on my tiptoes. That's actually really hard to stay up like that. Yeah, see, watch this. So hard to keep your balance. There's nothing solid to push against. And down I go. Okay, pull down. Nope, nope. Okay, there we go. I'm all the way to the bottom. I let go. How'd I come? All right, Kangen, you want to try standing in it? You got smaller feet, so.
Oh dear.
Yeah, I got a pair of boots for you.
These boots are huge.
Yeah, they're a little big for you. That'll actually help. You on the bottom?
Oh, man.
Okay. I got you. Are you floating?
Oh, that is so weird.
Like somebody's squeezing your feet?
Yes.
Can I let go of you?
Oh, gosh, no. Okay.
I got you.
I float a lot, like...
Well, you're lighter than me.
Well, yeah, but focus on them and see, like, how high I come up when I...
Okay. Step out.
Okay.
So there you have it. When I stood on Mercury, I only sunk into about mid-calf and became incredibly unstable. I think you still could walk on it or remain standing on it, maybe if you could widen your stance a bit and get a lot more practice. The problem was is my center of mass is all the way up here, whereas the Mercury was pushing me from way down there. And so if my center of mass got off from the center of lift, it would just force me over. Very easily. Usually when you're in water, the water comes like way up to your neck, so you know there's no problem there. But the Mercury, of course, is really dense, you know, 13 times denser than water, so you don't sink nearly that far. But the volume of my foot and a little bit of my leg was enough to displace my weight in Mercury, which is of course what you need to do in order to float. Now, you don't really need your weight of a liquid in order to float on it, of course. I mean, you could float a battleship in a glass of water if you could put it inside of a dish that is the exact right shape and size for it. What really matters is the pressure. And what I thought was really cool is when I was standing in the Mercury, it felt like my feet were being squeezed, because they were. Like my foot is kind of like a void and the Mercury is trying to flow into it, and that creates a lot of pressure, both on the sides and on the bottom. On the sides, the force kind of cancels out, and so it just, you know, squeezes tight. But on the bottom, that force is canceled by my body weight pulling down. And if I put more weight on, it'll sink down into the Mercury and get deeper, the pressure will increase, and the force will stabilize, assuming the Mercury is deep enough. Or if I'm too far down, the force of the Mercury will lift me up until the pressure decreases and it stabilizes. I thought that was really cool.
Standing on a foam mattress such as this feels a lot like standing on the Mercury. It's got a little bit of a give, but it does support your weight.
If this video is well received, I might try it again with a bunch more Mercury, a big wider dish, and see if I could actually walk on it. But right now I'm so sore from just carrying that quarter ton of Mercury around. We'll see how it goes. Until then, I'll see you next time.